We examine these books of seerah that we have. Anything that's compatible with the Quran, with the ahadith of Ahlul Bayt, with the character of the Prophet, we accept. Because the Prophet, he himself says, in a number of hadiths, he says, whatever you hear about me, if it's compatible with the book of God, accept it. If it's not, then reject it. And he warned the Prophet, peace be upon him, in our hadith books, even the Sunni hadith books, there are hadiths that say, the Prophet warned, he forewarned, that after me so many liars will come. تَكْثُرُ عَلَيَّ الْكَذَّابَ So many liars will come and they will forge hadiths. So be careful. Ibn Abbas, he has an interesting hadith. He says, if you ever hear me talking about the Prophet and giving you details, if you find that it contradicts the principles of the Quran and it's something that people find unacceptable, then know that I am lying. In other words, he's telling us that there's nothing about the Prophet's life that's immoral, that's unacceptable to society. So if you find a hadith that is difficult for society to accept, it's defaming the Prophet, it's contradicting the principles of Quran, automatically know that what? This is a false hadith. So the Imams of Ahlul Bayt, peace be upon them, they really contributed to giving us a picture of the Prophet's life. But we have to fill in the pieces. It's a big puzzle. We have to solve the puzzle. We have to look at every segment of the Prophet's life. First, see what exists in these biographies. And then we have to see, is this contradictory or not? Does this fit with the Quran or not? Does this fit with the personality of the Prophet or not? That gives us a better understanding of the Prophet's life.